Let's talk about your summer a little bit, man. What's it been like for you?
Summer's been good so far. You know, we only have a week and a couple of days left. And, you know, we've been doing a good job working out. Schmitty's been doing a great job pushing us and, you know, getting us stronger and getting our strength ready and whatnot. But you know, everything's looking good so far.
What are those Schmitty workouts like?
Very intense. You know, I mean, it's not much yelling, you know, if you do it right, if you go hard, but, you know, you have to go hard every snap. And, you know, we don't get a lot of time to recover because, you know, with our fast-paced offense, you know, I mean, I know us offensively, you know, we run a lot. You know, he don't give us too much time to recover. So, you know, we got to be on our P's and Q's, you know, when we're out there running and working hard. So,
what are your thoughts going into this season? You've dealt with some injuries, you've had some setbacks, but you've really excelled when you've been on the field. Can you just talk about your feeling going forward?
You know, I'm just ready to turn it up a notch. You know, last year I know I started a little slow. You know, that was my first surgery ever. You know, especially my first injury. Football related ever. So, you know, going through that, you know, second time having to go through the same time, you know, my mind is much more clear and, you know, much more prepared of, you know, the treatment and everything that I had to do to get back to, you know, my normal self. So, you know, I'm feeling good and I'm just ready to get back rolling.
Did you struggle at the beginning of the year as far as like just mentally saying I can make this cut, it's not that big a deal?
Yeah, it was a little mental as well as physical, you know, I mean, it still bothered me a little bit, but, you know, with all the media, you know, everyone asks me every day, how's your knee feelings, this what's going on, is that what's going on, you know, so I mean, it was a little mental, but I thought it was a lot more physical as well, you know, with it was still aching a little bit here and there, but, you know, I'm not going to let the media, you know, continue to ask me questions about what's wrong with me, you know, I'm going to probably allow one day, you know, during 2 days or whenever, you know, we have that chance just to cover questions about that, then I'm going to move on from it, but I mean, it was hard.
Has it been tough for you to miss the big games?
Yeah, it's very tough. You know, I mean, I had a chance to play last year, but I decided to, you know, go with the surgery and not, you know, ruin myself for, you know, in the future. You know, because
right.
I'm looking, I wasn't just going to look at, you know, this game. You know, all the coaches, you know, say, hey, you got to look at your future and got to look at what's best for, you know, what's best for me. You know, instead of what's best for the team at that point. You know, because I don't want to, you know, hurt myself to the point of there's no return. So. I mean, it was very hard, you know, missing the Big 12 as well as the championship game. You know, it was hard on me, but, you know, moved on from it.
Talk about just you and Chris and the way that you guys have worked so well together. 1,000 yards apiece, and nobody else in college football did that. Can you just talk about the way you guys work together?
We work hard. You know, we complement each other very well. And, you know, he's one of the hard-nosed, you know, run between the tackles. You know, I'm more of a flashy outside guy with speed, but... You know, we have a lot of similarities but a lot of differences, but, you know, we complement each other very well. You know, that's why we get along so well. That's why, you know, teams can't really stop us as much as they would like us like to. So, I mean, we're a great tandem, and, you know, I'm glad he's on my side.
What were your thoughts when you found out that the guys were coming back, like Sam and Jermaine?
I mean, I thought they were doing a great job, you know, coming back, you know, being able to get their education and becoming better football players. You know, both of them had something to improve on and make them a better player, but... No, I'm just glad they're back and, you know, looking to, you know, give another shot.
Talk about the Big 12 as a whole. I mean, there's a lot of the same guys you're going to be playing against this year. Talk about the conference. Just size that up.
You know, I mean, last year, you know, our conference was pretty good. You know, I think it was a good 3 or 4 teams in the top 5, you know, at one point. But, you know, our conference continued to grow, you know, trying to get up there with the SEC. You know, they have a lot of good teams. But, you know, the Big 12 is on the upcoming. You know, we have a lot of good teams and a lot of, you know, running backs, quarterbacks, a lot of high power offenses. But, you know, they don't really say too much about the defenses, you know, in Big 12 conferences. But I think we have pretty good defenses as well, you know, speaking of ours, a lot of players returning as well on defense. But, I mean, Big 12 conference is pretty tough, you know, but I'm sure they get better.
I know that you didn't get to play in the games, but the Big 12, I mean, the bowl losses have obviously been tough, you know, on the team year after year. How have they... You know, what's it been like in the offseason this year after losing to Florida, trying to just put it in the past and go forward with a new year?
You know, no one's really dwelled on it too much, you know, as bad as that sounds. But, you know, we moved on from it. You know, when we first got back, you know, people was like, ah, man, I can't believe we lost and whatnot. But, you know, going to the summer, you know, no one's talked about it. None of the coaches have brought it up. You know, we're a new team. You know, that old team is gone out the door. And, you know, we're just a new team trying to, you know, compete for another national championship and, you know, trying to do it again.
You like the no-huddle offense?
Yeah, I like it.
Because it's fast?
Yeah, it's fast. You know, it gives you more, you know, I guess it gives Sam more control of the offense, you know, and lets us, you know, just catch people off pace, you know, not have them, you know, they're not used to our tempo. You know, we're running pretty fast, so.
One of the biggest question marks that people are talking about with this team is offensive line. What are your thoughts on the guys that will be there for you?
You know, I know Trent is back, you know, so I'm not worried about him, but there's a lot of, you know, young guys that has to step up, you know, have to, you know, fill in those roles, you know, but I mean, I think we'll be good. You know, there's – there's a couple of young guys who, you know, has to continue to work hard and continue to, you know, come up. But, you know, it's up to us older guys to push them, you know, help them forward, you know, get a little extra film here and there. So, I mean, I think they'll be fine, you know, come game one.
Last thing, do you set personal goals? Are there things that you write down before a season starts that you want to achieve?
Yeah, I do. I mean, I don't share them with anyone. You know, I keep them to myself. But, you know, there's always personal goals that, you know, I try to achieve.
Is there anybody like AD, or is there anybody that you talk to, the former Sooners, or just guys that you look up to that have been in the game?
Well, you know, me and AD talk the most. You know, I mean, I talk to AP every now and then, Alan Patrick. But, you know, AD and I, we always text. You know, he's out here a couple weeks ago. We hang out, but. He's the guy that I talk to the most and text back and forth, you know, but he's always busy with a lot of stuff, so you got to catch him on a good day. But, I mean, he's a good guy, but he's one of the players that, you know, we communicate very often.
All right. Thanks a lot. Thank you. Appreciate it.